Alright guys, be trying to do a quick video here. Finally got the system in the vehicle. And got this Crossfire DB3 10 inch. And it's got a little dent in the dust cover or whatever. Not a big deal. These Scosche HD 6.5s. They call them subwoofers, but yes, they pump out bass, but they're not really. I wouldn't consider them a subwoofer, they're a speaker. Don't mind the trash, I need to clean it out. It's got these horn tweeters in here on both sides. Nice carbon fiber box. Pick these up for 30 bucks. This honestly was free, it was a gift. I have bought an amp, I have it up front, but I don't have it with me. Or I'm not gonna show you guys. I might, I don't know. Not really prepared for this video, I gotta do it quick. Running a dual 400 watt 1/2 channel amp. I got that hooked up, that's hardwired in there. I showed you guys that earlier. I got these 2 6.5s hooked up along with the 10 inch to the 2 channel. The 10 inch is bridged and these two are just wired on each channel. This is bridged between both of them. I got it rigged. Hate to say that, but I'm running a dual head unit. I'll go up there and show you guys that. Don't mind the trash, like I said. Scosche wiring kit. It's a XD250. In my opinion, it's, like I said, nothing special, nothing spectacular. Like I said, I tried to get it as a budget system. Oh, yeah, I do have the amp. I thought I did, but I wasn't sure. Had an AudioVox Rampage 500 watt and for some reason I don't know what it is, but it kept cutting out, so I had to buy the dual. I mean, I understand I only paid 15 bucks for this, but no, it wasn't brand new, it was used. But yeah, I don't know, just didn't do what I expected it to. So find something on my phone to test, show you guys. I mean, it's not a loud system, but it hits. It does what it's supposed to. Sorry for zooming in on the Rampage. But with it being hot like this, I need to get a cooling fan because it's almost overheating my amp. It's bad. Really bad. Give me a minute, I'll set you guys down. It's on 15. Catch him. Yeah, you can't that's my system. Sorry, I'm kind of out in the middle of nowhere right now. But I got a maximum of $150 in this whole system. And that's including buying that with it not working. For that much cash, you can't bitch. That's what I wanted to do. But I've already come to the conclusion. My next vehicle, whatever I get, I'm getting dual 15s regardless. And that's it, guys. I don't know if it matters, but or any of you want to know, I'm running a monster auxiliary cable. It's 7 foot. It's the only one Walmart had. This is basically a Walmart system. That it don't sound too bad. Yeah, I need to get something in there, but I mean, yeah, like I said, for a cheap system, you can't bitch. It's great. Now, I can't put it up against real expensive systems, but for some people, they got like dual brand 12s, I'll blow them out of water. My friend's got explodes. He's got dual 10s in his truck. I blew them out of the water, and he's running a 1200 watt amp. I'm running 4. On top of that, his girlfriend has dual 12s that are explodes, and I was keeping up with them. And personally, yeah, because it's mine, I'm going to say it's better. But I honestly thought it sounded better. And unlike his, mine doesn't have where you can hear your vehicle rattling apart. Because this vehicle had a system in it before and has the dynamat inside. So, yeah. That's my system, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Getting back to you sometime, making more videos, more updates. Any questions, comments, no negative bullshit, but anything you want to ask, go right ahead. Anything you want to suggest, like I need a suggestion to keep my amp cool so it doesn't overheat on days like today. It's 95 degrees out and I can play it for maybe 20 minutes before it wants to take a shit. So any ideas there would be a great help. Other than that, yeah, comment, tell me what I need, tell me what if there's anything I did wrong, besides getting dual brand stuff. I understand, it sucks, but I guess what I want done, so, yep, later.